Hey, what is up, Pokey Nerds? My name is StarWarsFan4505, and today I'm going to be showing you my top 10 favorite Pokemon, and I'll be telling you why they are my favorites. So, starting with number 10, we have Gardevoir. Gardevoir is my favorite Pokemon, or is my 10th favorite Pokemon, because she was the very first holographic pull I've ever gotten. And basically, it's been pretty big since it was my very first, you know, pretty good, rare sort of pull. So yeah, that's why it's 10th in my list. Number 9, Charizard. Probably know why Charizard is 9th on my list, but for some of you who don't, basically because Charizard, the first shiny card I've ever pulled. So, yeah. Thank you, Charizard. That is why you are 9th on my list. Number 8, Houndour. Now, Houndour is number 8 because he's just an awesome looking Pokemon. And this card is just basically just awesome. So, I like the design of Houndour and all that stuff like that, and it's also my second holo card that I bought, but, you know, it's old school, which is good, that's why I bought it. It's from Neo Discovery, I'm pretty sure. And it just looks awesome. So Houndour is number 8 on my list. Number 7 on my list is Genesect. He hasn't come out as a card yet, but he has come out in Pokemon Black 2. So I'll just let you take a quick look at that. He's level 100, as you see. It was a Wi-Fi gift, as you can see there. And yeah, I just kind of find humor in one-shotting wild Pokemon and other Pokemon with Signal Beam. So, yeah. That's why Genesect is number 7 on my list. He's not a card form. He's coming out in Plasma Blast, which I'm sure to go to the pre-release, hopefully. Maybe get a booster box the day it comes out, if I have enough money. I have around $70 and higher, so I just need a couple more stuff to get that. So, yeah, Genesect, you helped me a lot. You beat the Elite Four without any help from any of the other Pokemon in my party, and that's why you're number 7. Number 6, Umbreon. Now, Umbreon is number 6 in my list because he used to be my favorite Pokemon, and I love the evolutions, and he's my favorite evolution. So, yeah, he used to be my favorite Pokemon, and I have a soft spot for dark types, So, yeah, that's why he is number 6 on my list. Yeah. Number 5, Kranidos. Now, Kranidos, he used to be my favorite Pokemon as well. And he was my very first Pokemon card ever pulled when Diamond and Pearl sets came out, before I started making YouTube videos. I was 6, 7-ish, I don't know, 5, 6, 7-ish. Basically, he got me into Pokemon, and for all of you fans who love my videos, or not love, but at least like my videos, you should give a lot of credit to Kranidos. You should thank him, you know, maybe add him to your top 10, who knows. Thank you, Kranidos, for getting me into Pokemon. Maybe we'll see you in another video of my top 10 favorite Pokemon, but higher in the list. That was 5, correct? Yeah. Number 4, Turtwig. Now, Turtwig is number 4 on my list because my first Pokemon game, I chose Turtwig as my starter. Which was a Diamond and Pearl one. I'm not sure which game it was specifically, but Sinnoh Regions or something like that. I don't know. You can list some of the Diamond and Pearl games down below and get the name back in my head once I see it, because I have a good good thing there. Sorry about that. But, you know, if you guys list any of the Diamond and Pearl games down below, I'm pretty sure I'll get the name back into my head and just create a video response or respond on the comments. So, yeah. That's why Turtwig is number 4 on my list. Number 3, I don't have a card of, or not on my game, but it's Blastoise. Now, Blastoise, he's been a big part of my Pokemon life as well. When I was around 5-ish still, I had a plushie. It was a blue turtle with, like, guns on its back. And I didn't know, like, what it was. I knew it was, like, a stuffed toy turtle thingy, but I didn't know it was like a Pokemon or from Pokemon. So once I found out, it was a Pokemon, I started getting into Pokemon around that age. I'm pretty sure he was my very first plushie, and so it impacted me a lot of my Pokemon life. Number 2 on the list, Dialga. Now, Dialga also used to be my favorite Pokemon, but he's my favorite legendary of all time, so that's why he belongs in number 2 on this list. So, yeah. Dialga looks amazing, and all that stuff. So, he's also coming out as a new card in Plasma Blast as an EX and an EX Full Art, so I'll be hoping to get that too. So, yeah. Now, number 1, most of you already know this, but Absol. Absol is my favorite Pokemon. Absol is my favorite Pokemon because he just looks badass. Sorry about that. As I said, I have a soft spot for Darkness Pokemon. He looks awesome. And who wouldn't want a Pokemon who can sense danger with a horn on its head. Yeah. So that's pretty awesome. Thank you, Horny Absol, for being number one on my list. So you'll probably be my number one favorite Pokemon of all time. Talking to a card here. Check myself into a mental hospital. Anyways, so yeah, that was my top 10 favorite Pokemon of all time. Now, number 11, which I wouldn't do because it's an odd number. But number 11, three words. Or blech. Number 11 is Ditto. Three words, the Masuda Method. That's right. So that would be number 11 if I did a top 20 thing. But I probably won't. Because it's hard for me to pick out top 10, so, yeah. Sorry about the weird sort of comments in this video. My brain farts and everything like that. So, I'm trying to be more professional about this. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. And on Sundays, I'll be starting a new series called All About Me. I'll basically be telling you guys, just basically the title of the video, all about myself. So, yeah, that'll be every Sundays. Yeah, so I'll be making a video after this one, I guess, later though. So, about, trading GTS on the black version 2, stuff like that. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and guess you'll see me in the next video. Bye.